Can malware survive if I reset my PC? Hi everyone, Leo Neltenboom here for askleo.com. A very simple question. Can a virus survive Windows reset this PC and remove everything? Technically, yes. Certain types of malware can survive a reset. Pragmatically though, these types of malware are very rare, especially if you take a couple of additional steps as you remove everything. I'll say that there are three places malware could, in theory, survive the default remove everything option in Windows reset this PC process. Rootkits. A rootkit is malware that takes additional steps to hide its very existence from the operating system. This means that when reset this PC deletes the existing files on the hard disk or moves them aside into a Windows.old folder, the rootkit could survive to reinfect the resulting clean installation of Windows. Partitions. Malware could install itself, or a copy of itself, into one of the reserved partitions, including the recovery partition from which Windows would be reinstalled. The fresh copy of Windows could then come with malware. Firmware. Some malware infects the firmware on your machine, such as your BIOS or UEFI. By definition, this is the software that runs on every boot and manages access to certain hardware. It's not affected by reset this PC. All right, let's walk through resetting the PC. I'm right-clicking on Start, clicking on Settings, then searching for Reset, because that's probably the fastest way to find what we want here. Reset this PC. When you reset your computer, one option you select at the very beginning is whether or not to remove your files. The default is to keep your personal files. It's probably a bad idea. This probably means keeping the files in your documents folder and a few similar locations, but it's unclear how much is kept. Regardless, if one of those files is infected, then, yeah, this presents an opportunity for that infection to persist. So, choose remove everything. Now, in my case, because of the way this machine is set up, I'm not being shown an intermediary option that I also want you to understand. You'll be asked if you want Windows to be downloaded or if a local copy should be used. A local reinstall would be faster, but as I noted, there's an extremely slim possibility that the local copy of Windows, which is on one of those hidden partitions used for this reinstall, could have been compromised by malware. So, if you are asked and you have the opportunity, choose a cloud download. My machine's not even asking me because that hidden partition doesn't exist. It's going to do a cloud download anyway, which is exactly what we want. So far, we now have a list of what we've chosen so far. In my case, remove apps and files, do not clean the drive, we'll talk about that, and delete all files only from the Windows drive, we'll talk about that too. You will hopefully see a download and reinstall Windows if that was an option for you to pick. I'm going to change settings. Clean data. I want to clean data. This will actually clean everything from the drive. It will take extra time. You can see that it talks about it taking hours, but it will indeed make it harder to recover any files should that be of a concern. Delete files from all drives. Well, if you've got multiple drives, malware could be on any of those drives. In which case, you probably want to make sure that all of the files on all of the drives will, in fact, be removed. We'll click on Confirm, and we've got the settings chosen that we want. We'll click on Next, and it's off doing whatever it's going to do to perform this reset. Here's the problem. We still don't really know that everything on this hard disk is going to be erased. We still don't know if there's malware in a hidden partition somewhere. My recommendation, if you are truly concerned about this, is not to use reset this PC. The only way to be sure that everything on the hard drive is truly removed is to boot from a Windows setup disk and reinstall Windows from scratch. Let me show you what that looks like. All right, I've rebooted this machine from a Windows setup disk, like we were setting up Windows from scratch for the very first time. Even this isn't enough. We're going to need to take some specific steps along the way. Let me show you what I mean. Language, time, and currency, of course, that's up to you. Keyboard or input method, that too is up to you. What do we want to do? We want to install Windows 11. I agree that everything will be deleted. No product key. This is Windows 11 Pro. Of course, we have to accept the licensing. All right, this is where we need to pay attention. This is showing us all of the disks and all of the partitions that are available on this machine. We don't know what's in these partitions. We can guess based on their size that this is probably the old original partition, but what we're going to do for each of these partitions is delete it. We do this until the drive we want to install on has only unallocated space. So we've literally deleted everything on that hard disk, all the hidden partitions, the boot partition, Windows itself, etc. The malware isn't going to be there anymore because we've deleted absolutely everything. We'll go ahead and click Next. We don't need to create partitions. Windows will now do that for us. We'll click on Next, and we're ready to install. Install Windows 11 Pro and keep nothing, which is exactly what we want. And off goes the install process. Now, this covers everything, honestly, that's in your control. But it's still doesn't cover absolutely everything. We haven't touched the firmware. Now, again, it is extremely rare, but malware entrenched in firmware is significantly more difficult to remove. Nothing we've done will affect malware that actually made it into your UEFI or BIOS. The only thing you can try if you are convinced that there's malware in your firmware is you can try the procedure outlined by your computer manufacturer to update your UEFI or BIOS, even if you are updating to the exact same version as is already installed. Yes, other devices could also be compromised, and they may or may not have similar procedures for updating or replacing the firmware. But the problem here, of course, is knowing which are installed on your system and whether or not this is even an option for them. There really is just no easy answer when it comes to firmware. So, bottom line. Well, to start, don't panic. It's easy to become very concerned having walked through all of these things that you might have to do. I'll put it this way. You should never, ever, ever jump to the conclusion that you have persistent malware that cannot be removed. Never. I hear from people all the time who are absolutely convinced that they have malware that cannot be removed, be it in their BIOS, their UEFI, or somewhere else. As long as I've been doing this, 22 years now, I have yet to actually encounter it, not even once. Like I said, it's extremely rare. There has always been some other fixable explanation. If you truly suspect that that's the case on your machine, take it to a professional for a more detailed analysis before throwing in the towel. Just because something is possible doesn't mean it's likely. But so far, now, you understand the steps that you would need to go through with reset this PC to improve your odds of not allowing malware to persist, or using a completely clean Windows setup from scratch to do the same. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/ 1-1-9-9-9-7. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.